Welcome to 77 Paisa channel. Please see the channel description to know more about this channel and myself. Today it's going to be another important topic, which is around the CIBIL credit score. So today if you Google around for CIBIL score, you'll find a lot of blogs and videos around how to improve your credit score. There are a few good points, but there are a lot of points that are misleading for the customer. That is what at least I think. So today I will share with you what I think is the best strategy to improve your credit score. Let's start with the recap of the CIBIL score and how it impacts the lending process. A CIBIL score is a number between 350 and 900 that indicates your creditworthiness. The higher the number, banks will consider you more creditworthy and the chances of your loan getting approved is higher. So here is a simple process flow diagram that tells you how credit score is determined and how a lending process consumes that credit score. You see a yellow color line in the middle of the screen. That left hand side of that is how credit score is calculated. So let's start from there. Let's assume that you already have a couple of credit cards and one car loan for which you are paying the EMI. So each and every month, both these credit card companies and also the bank with whom you have taken a car loan, they will be sending all the loan and credit card balance and all those details to TransUnion. TransUnion is a multinational company that has a proprietary algorithm or formula to calculate the CIBIL score. So each month for each and every individual, they get such reports and they generate what is called as a credit information report, and also they come up with this credit score, which is also called as a CIBIL score. So this is how the credit scoring is done. Now the same customer, let's say he is applying for a personal loan. So he is applying for a personal loan through a new bank or with an existing bank itself. So what happens is, now the bank with whom the customer has applied for a new loan reaches out to TransUnion and gets their CIBIL score. Then they check, based upon certain rules, they check whether the customer is eligible for a loan based upon the CIBIL score. So if they think that the customer has got a good CIBIL score, they will take it to the next step. If they think that the CIBIL score is too low, they will decline the loan there itself. As part of the next step, they will be having few other parameters or rules in addition to the CIBIL score. For example, your employment status, how much salary you make and how much EMI you are already paying, which city you live in, these are some, and what job you do. These are some of the other factors, I mean, other than CIBIL, the factors that could impact the decision on your loan. So having a good CIBIL score is important to get a loan, but having a good credit score alone will not get you that credit card or a loan. For example, some companies may not offer a credit card for a lawyer. Some companies, for example, Amex and Citibank, they do not offer most of their products to non-metro customers. And almost all the banks, they take a look at how much EMI you are paying and how much your monthly salary. And if you're already paying 60% of your monthly salary as your EMI, they will not give you any loan. So these are the very basic things that you have to keep in mind. So now let's focus on our topic, how to increase your credit score. As I said earlier, in the internet, there are a lot of articles and videos that teaches you how to increase your CIBIL score. But as I told earlier, I do not agree with most of the points. As far as I am concerned, the only way to increase your credit score is by ensuring that your credit score doesn't decrease. So what I mean is, you will have control around ensuring that your credit score is not decreasing, but you do not have much control around increasing your credit score. So keep ensuring that you do not your credit score down. Over a period of time, your credit score will gradually increase. There is no shortcut to increase it in a quick time or quick manner. So before we get into the details of how to ensure that, you need to understand the components of your credit score. What decreases your credit score? Only if you know what decreases your credit score, you can ensure that it doesn't go down. There are four things. The most important one is the loan repayment performance. The next one is credit exposure. Other one is credit type and duration, and few other factors. We'll see about each one of these in detail now. The first factor is the loan repayment performance. This is the most important factor, because any negative impact to your credit score due to this factor will take a very long time to correct. For example, if you commit a fraud or if you default on an EMI payment, it will impact your credit score negatively. And for you to recover from that negative impact, it will take 5 to 7 years. Today, if you default on a loan, if you stop paying a loan, it will impact your credit score immediately. And for you to recover from that, it will take 5 or 7 years to come out of it. So be very careful. Ensure that there is no default, there is no fraud, there is no foreclosure and seizure of assets. And also ensure that there is no late payment of your EMIs and credit card bills. Even in cases of any disputes around your credit card bills, make sure that you make at least the minimum payment on time, and then open up a dispute with your credit card company, and then parallelly try to address that dispute. Do not delay on the payment. The next important factor is credit exposure. It is a measure of how much credit limit or credit capacity you have and how much of credit limit have you used. It's always good to keep it around 30%. So what it means is, if you have a credit limit of 1 lakh rupees on your credit card, ensure that your outstanding balance on that card never goes beyond 30%. But there could be some scenarios where it is unavoidable. In such situations, use the following 4 strategies. Try to apply for your second or third card and split the transactions across multiple cards. Next option is to go and request for a credit card limit increase on your existing card. So if you want to do a purchase of 80,000 on a 1 lakh card, it is 80% of your limit. But if you approach your bank and they agree to increase the credit limit from 1 lakh to 3 lakh rupees, your credit exposure comes to less than 30%. So try that out. The last option, which is my preferred option that I always do whenever I make a big purchase, is to prepay the credit card bills. So as I told earlier, only at the end of the billing cycle, your credit card company send the credit data to CIBIL. So what you have to do is, if you are doing that big ticket purchase today, within the next 7 days or 10 days before the next billing cycle, before the current billing cycle ends, go ahead and prepay the amount from your bank balance. So that will ensure that when your credit card company reports to CIBIL, your credit card exposure comes down to less than 30%. Also try to pre-close your vehicle and personal loans whenever possible if you are going for a bigger loan like a home loan. So the next factor is credit type and duration. Credit cards, home loans, personal loans, vehicle loans, these are the different types of credits, and the higher the number of credit types, the more will be your credit score. But my strong suggestion to you is, do not go for a new credit type just for the sake of increasing your credit type number, because a new loan will also have a negative impact on your credit score, which you'll be seeing after this factor. So just stay where you are. Do not apply for a new credit type just for the sake of increasing your credit score. Next one is duration. It has 2 dimensions. Number one is how long you have a credit history, and number two is average age of your credit. So in order to have a longer duration, make a careful selection of your first credit card. Whenever you apply for your first credit card, make sure that it is a card with decent benefits and it has got no annual fee. Never cancel that card. Keep that card forever. And as far as the average age is concerned, this is typically applicable for credit card churners who get credit cards just for the sake of getting rewards and cancel the credit cards in 1 year or so. So for those, the strategy for those churners should be something like, keep churning only the latest credit cards. So you get a credit card this year, cancel that credit card next year and go for a new card. Do not churn your old cards. Particularly if you have a card that has got no annual fee, never churn that card at all. Apart from the 3 factors that we saw till now, there are also other factors that may negatively impact your credit score. But the good thing about these other factors is that their weightage is low and also the impacted duration is short for them. One such example is with the credit hungriness. It is a measure of the number of applications that you made in the trailing 12 months. If you have made an application for 3 or more credit cards or loans in the last 12 months, it will negatively impact your credit score. As I told you earlier, the approval of a credit application doesn't depend only on the CIBIL score. It depends upon other factors like your salary and the EMI that you are already paying, what kind of job you are in, which city you live, and so on and so forth. So whenever you are applying for a credit card or a loan, keep these factors in mind and apply judiciously. That would ensure that your credit score doesn't come down. But there could be certain situations, particularly for the credit card reward chasers, where they may think that, okay, there are like, they may see three or four good credit card offers coming in and they may want to apply for all of them. Just go ahead and apply for all of them, provided you do not have a big vehicle loan or home loan coming in the next 12 months. Apply all of them together on the same day or within 1 week, so that slowly over a period of 12 months, the negative impact of those four applications will go down, after which you can apply for new loans or new credit cards. Thank you for watching. If you strictly follow the suggestions that I have given around those four factors, you can definitely ensure that your credit score doesn't go down. And if that happens over a period of time, your credit score will gradually start increasing. If you found this video informative, please like this video, share this video, and subscribe to my channel. If you have any feedback, questions, or comments, use the comment section and we'll respond as soon as possible. Also, in the video description, I have given the link to the FAQ section of the official TransUnion CIBIL website. Please take a look at that FAQs and read it for yourself. Thanks and bye-bye.